When a man dreams of his destiny for long enough, it becomes a reality shaped by his undying will and unfathomable desire. Like my old friend used to say, "Stay a while and listen, brave Nephilim, for I'm about to tell you a tale of a great city long thought to be lost in the frost of time. It began, surprisingly, only a day ago when a young barbarian woke up from a dream and realized all was not same. An old enemy has risen and sought for his help. Unmoved by his emotions, the barbarian surprisingly agreed to help the old Kul. After all, the promise was to unite him with his homeland, so he strode on, amidst the ruins of Ariat, his old home and the heart of the barbarian horde. His people, proud and strong, were all but quelled by the great Lord Baal and his hellish horde. Now he enters the ruins and finds the same old familiar feeling. A feeling of rest, of peace, and of pride. The young barbarian entered the first watchtower of Secheron. The watchtower was empty. No sign of his people, just ruins of dread chiseled on the stone floor. He strode on. The watchtower almost looked the same. Almost. Outside the great tower, he found what he was dreading the most. A horde of demons and foul beasts as far as his eyes could see. He reached out for his mighty sword and did what he does best, quell every single one of them. As he danced the dance of death, he began to think, should he go back? But something kept calling him and he danced forward. He knew he wouldn't be alone in Secheron, and his doubts were soon put to rest as he rescued his fellow brethren who perhaps had the same dream. The dream he had before when he saw the reincarnation of Kul. He did not wait to ask them anything. He just strode on. He heard a voice in the distance, a man crying for help. Surrounded by a host of spearmen, the young barbarian freed him and found out that man was none other than the great explorer Abd al-Azir. The scholar was shaken, but barbarian promised to keep him safe if scholar would tell him the reason for his visiting these ruins. And so a deal was made. He cracked the rotten door open and marched in the next hall. No signs of life here too. Just the foul creatures who now infest this sacred ground. A ground that worshipped not any gods or men, but might and might alone. Whoever holds the heart and bears the courage to quell evil would reside in this hall as its ruler. You see, barbarians follow only strength. They believe that a man's will is stronger than man himself. For a man may die and fall in battle, but his will does possess a strength that enters the soul of another barbarian, and another one after that, until the entire strength of a barbarian horde resides in one man. The young barbarian knew this strength all too well, as he has heard of the great immortal king. The one true king of the barbarian horde that ruled in an age long ago. Perhaps it was his great king that beckoned him from far beyond. Perhaps. He strode on, quelling countless of beasts, but was stopped in his track by a strange sight. The wise elder, Garan of his tribe, stood in front of him, but rather than his usual self, he was possessed by evil and his soul had been tainted over the ages. With heavy heart, he fought the great elder and brought him down at the entrance of the elder sanctum. He now knew his purpose was clear. He must explore further and find out the meaning of this dream. The elder sanctum was heavily plagued by foul beasts and demons. Like old Garan used to say, evil, like sickness, spreads from within. Just like an old tree withers from its roots, so did Secheron fall once the elder sanctum had fallen to the eternal corruption. His dance of the whirlwinds allowed him to cut through these hordes with ease, and in the fury of his mighty rage, he did not realize he now stood at the foot of the immortal throne. His quest was nearing his end as he was hoping to meet the great king himself. He marched on further and saw a great visage sit proudly on the throne. What was he thinking? The king had been dead for a long time. He stood in front of his resting king and bowed in silence. And then he swiftly marched away without saying a word. He could still feel the power scintillating from the elder sanctum, so his final wish was to seek out the cause of this. No emotions followed him, just grim resolve. It has been a long journey, but he was not about to stop now. He fought more and finally reached a room where rested a magical artifact. Could this really be the prize Kul was talking about? The young barbarian wondered as he approached the relic. He hesitated but then felt immense strength engulf his soul. He saw his great king appear before him and pointed to the artifact. He picked it up hastily and was greeted by Kul. The malevolent being was congratulating him on his victory, but the young barbarian simply returned home with Abdulazir. He knew what he found was powerful, but his real reward was to meet his king one last time. His resolve was stern, his strength was renewed. He knew what his purpose was. The barbarian kingdom might be in ruin, but his horde's strength never was in castles or walls, but in its people. He is now one of the few surviving barbarians in the sanctuary, and unlike his great king, his tale has only just begun.